Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to explain how to use three-tier architecture for web development or an app development. I'm sure you know what three-tier architecture is, but many students don't know how it is actually used to build an application. And if you notice in my YouTube videos, I always try to give very simple illustrations, and that's because simple examples can make a complex topic easy to understand. And even in this video, that's what I believe. And even in this video, I'm going to explain to you the architecture and its applications in practical scenarios. I wanted to create this video first because, as you know, we're soon going to create a web app with Flask. I'm going to explain the terms used in this framework and how you can use it while creating a new application. Okay, so whether you're trying to create a web application or you're trying to create a mobile app, you can use this three-tier architecture. Before I start this video, if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe, like this video and share it with your friends. And let's start with the architecture first. And as I explain these layers or these tiers, I'm also going to tell you how they are used while developing an application. Okay, so this three-tier architecture was developed by John J. Donovan. That's his name. And this architecture has three layers or three tiers, and every tier represents a part of the application or the product that we're trying to create. Okay, so when you create an application, I will also explain three tiers, but first of all, I want to clear a few things. So when you create an application, there are three things you should consider: stair, smartness, and storage. So if you are confused with three-tier architecture, you just need to remember these three S: stair, smartness, and storage. Okay, so stair. How does application looks like when you stare at it? When you look at it, how does it look like? How smart is this application? Is it able to do what it's supposed to do? And can it store data for future reference? Okay, so these are three aspects of an application, any application that you want to create, and you want it to survive for years should have these three elements. Now, let's see how three-tier architecture helps in creating this type of application. So the first tier or layer of this architecture is the presentation layer or presentation tier. And this tier deals with the staring part of the application. When you look at the application, how does it look like? Its user interface. How presentable is it? It is, and how do you make an application presentable? What are the elements that you can add, right? And how do you create an interface for the application? Now see, this part is associated with the interface. The interface will connect the user and the application. So this is like the door, and the user will enter using this door, right? So you have to make it look appealing to the user. And for the presentation tier, you can use HTML, or you can also use CSS, right? Cascading style sheets to make your HTML content look more presentable. Moving on to second tier or second layer. So second tier is business tier. And in this tier, we talk about the logic. So once you look at the application, or when even when you go to a website, right, the first thing that you see is the presentation. How does it look like? So that is the interface. And second part is the business tier. What is it going to do? How is the system or the application working? Okay, so for that, we make use of programming languages such as Python, right, to implement the logic. We make use of variables, loops, and you know, different types of constructs in the programming language, depending on all that is available in the programming language. So that is what business tier is, right? How is the application working, right? Third tier is data tier, and it deals with data storage issues. How is data stored? What kind of server are we using? What are the security practices? Because whatever program you create on your system are actually being executed in the main memory. So when you shut down the computer, data is erased. Obviously the file in which you wrote the program is not erased. And I've actually created a full video on this concept, and I'm sharing the link above the screen in the icons. On the whole, if you want to save data, for example, you want to save your login information, your passwords, you have to have a database or a storage mechanism, right? For example, when you log into your Gmail account, right, when you need to open your email, so you log into your Gmail account, the first thing that you see on the screen is the login page. So that is the interface, right? And when you look at the interface, you get to know that you're supposed to fill in your login information, your email address and your password. And if you have enabled 2FA, which is that's two-factor authentication, then those kind of details, right? So that is the presentation tier, your interface. And once you are logged in, you get to see another interface, right? And there you have your emails. You have different options. You can create an email. You can check all the emails that you have received. You can send an email, right? So these are all the different options. And this is what Gmail or your email application is doing. That is what it does. So that is the business tier, right? The logic part. And when you have to log in, so let's say you are done with your email, you wanted to send somebody an email, and you also wanted to check your email, so you're done with that, and then you log out from your email account. Next time when you log in again, you have to fill in your email address and your password. So the first time, let's say when you don't have an account on Gmail, okay, you will create an account on Gmail, and you will have to fill in your email address for the first time, your details and your password. For the second time, next time when you log in, you don't have to sign up, right? Because you already have an account and the information is stored in the database, right? So next time when you try to log in, that same information is fetched from the database and you are logged in again. You need to fill in your email address, you need to fill in your password, and all this information that you're typing in is checked. It is validated, it is verified in the database, and if the information is already there, based on the information in the database, you are logged into your Gmail account, your email account, right? And if the information is not there, then you will receive a message that you don't have an account, you will have to sign up and all of that. So data tier is concerned, data tier deals with those kind of issues, data storage issues, okay, how your data is being stored, what kind of database we're using, what kind of query language is being used and all of that. And server, you know, whether distributed server is being used and all of that. So I have created a full video on this concept. I'll share the link, and I hope you understood why data tower is being used, and I really hope you understood this. So on the whole, if you want to save your data and you want to fetch it again in the future, like I gave you this example of login information and passwords, you have to have database or storage mechanism. All right. So this is what three-tier architecture is, and this is how it is related to actual web application development. And actually, in the next video, we're going to create a web application using Flask, HTML, and I will also explain this framework, this three-tier architecture again as we create our web application. So I'll see you in the next video. And if you have any queries or suggestions, let me know in the comments below. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care.